I'm Chief Meteorologist Derek Snoddle. We are live in the Weather Center right now. You like my new face mask, by the way? Got a couple of these. They fit my face better. The other one I had kind of felt like either my head was too gigantic or the face mask was too small, and it was always very off-putting for me. So I like the fact that it fits better. All right, let's run this through. It's, been cloudy again, and it will probably be cloudy through most of our night. I tweeted this earlier. You've got to go all the way back to November 10th. The last time that the Rochester airport registered a sunny day, a clear day. Isn't that something else? It has been almost 2 months. We still have the clouds here tonight. We advertised a few flurries, and you can see that showing up here. This is a really sensitive mode of our radar, but we still have this very persistent northerly flow coming in off of Lake Ontario like that. And temperatures are below freezing, so even though the air temperature difference between the warm water is minuscule, it's enough to get a few of those flurries going. The bigger storm system, where all the fun is tonight, well, that's across the deep south. You can see the big spiral here. So we're all circulating into the center of low pressure right about in there. As that low continues to do a path like this, you will end up getting some colder air to funnel in. They are already now this evening turning things over to snow. I would argue it's snowing more right now in North Alabama than it is in the western New York region. That snow starting to mix in and around Florence. We've got some snow mixing in now north of Atlanta, Georgia. They're expecting several inches of snow, in fact, into parts of Tennessee, going into South and North Carolina. That system will spare us. It is going to exit more to the right, to the east, versus moving northeast toward us. So we will not get any influence from that, which is good if you want to get some sunshine, because I'm with you there. I'd be all right with a little sunshine. Early tomorrow, first part of the day tomorrow, I think that's the process of the drier air winning out. I certainly would not advertise mostly sunny skies in the morning. I think the best bet here tomorrow to get some of that sunshine will be in the afternoon, and especially later in the afternoon. Every hour that passes by offers a higher chance, a higher likelihood of getting into some of that sunshine, but we should get there, and we should stay there getting into Saturday. That is your best day here for vitamin D, and I know what Saturday is. That's our big Bills game, and the vast majority of you are going to be inside watching that game. I'm just warning you now. If you don't take an opportunity to get some of that sunshine, you are going to miss the opportunity. Cloudy skies return by Sunday, and we should stay at least mostly cloudy going into next week. Now, this clearing offers us an opportunity to see a sky show that, you know, these last few it felt like we have missed here in western New York because of our abundant cloud cover. This is the planetary trio. So the rule of thumb with this, Friday night and Saturday nights will probably be the only ones we would get a chance to see this. You're going to go outside about 45 minutes after sunset. Sunset now is just shy of 5 p.m. You're going to look off to the west. You're going to see three points of light, all of which you don't need a telescope. You don't need binoculars. You just need the naked eye. Those are going to be all planets. You've got Jupiter, Saturn, and Mercury shining bright enough to see. And this camera is actually pointed off to the northwest. That's the stuff we got to get rid of, that cloud cover. But I think we do get that later tomorrow and again on Saturday. And we get to watch a Bills game with sunshine at Orchard Park in January, which is almost unheard of. Temperatures there should be largely right around the freezing mark. You might get a degree or two above, but we don't see precip being an issue. I've got winds out of the north, maybe around 10 miles an hour, certainly not significant. The weather going into this weekend is cool. You know, we got highs upper 20s to the mid 30s. That's our range. That's not super cold. It's obviously not warm, just cool. What we've been spared through the better part of the winter has been this stuff, that pink color, which is the true and the genuine Arctic air. That's been bottled up in Canada. And eventually that dam has got to break. And I'm not insinuating that the dam is going to fully break the following weekend, but we're getting signs that we're kind of transitioning more toward that general direction. So I think not this weekend, but the following one. Do the floodgates open, or is this more of a glancing blow? That still remains to be seen. Regardless, it's going to be a change in the pattern toward colder. Regardless, it's going to be a change in the pattern likely towards snowier, too. So some of you snow fans who have been largely left out here for these last couple of months, that might be a better opportunity for you. For the non-snow fans, you've got about another 7 or 8 days. And then it does appear we turn that on its head a little bit. There's your 8-day forecast. Beyond the weekend, not much changes, no major storm systems from Monday through Thursday. The next shot of precip right now, we target Friday of next week. That's a long ways out in the crystal ball, so obviously no specifics with that. but that appears to be the general pattern for your next storm system that we would have to watch. We'll see you back on air at 11 o'clock. You can join me on Facebook Live on the WROC News 8 page at 9:30.